Now for the ridiculous, Randy, and tonight we're adding Southwest Airlines. Why? Because a Southwest pilot recently brought it to our attention that the quality of flight attendants on the airline is, in his opinion, well, kind of lacking. And by quality, he doesn't mean their professionalism, which they have, or safety training, which they have, or how they treat passengers, which is good. Oh, no. This pilot is talking strictly about the dearth of flight attendants who are suitable sex partners for him. How do I know this, you ask? Because his mic was open during a flight, and this guy would just not shut up.
I had Tucson, Indy, all 4 weeks. And Chicago cruise, 11 out of 12. There's 12 flight attendants, individual, never the same flight attendant twice. 11 over the top homosexuals and a granny. 11. I mean, think of the odds of that. I thought I was in Chicago, which was party land. After that, it was just a continuous stream of gays and grannies and grandes.
Gays and grannies and grandes. What a charmer this guy is. I take it a grande would be a flight attendant who doesn't measure up to Captain Integrity's standards of slimness. How does he work under these conditions? I mean, with all these gay people and older and overweight flight attendants running around, who's he supposed to go out drinking with in between flights?
So, 6 months, I went to the bar 3 times. In 6 months, 3 times.
6 months, just 3 times. Unacceptable. Why else did this guy become a pilot if it wasn't to hit on flight attendants? Listen, airlines, I fly a lot, and I want my pilots happy. I'm putting my life in their hands, so I definitely want them to be out drinking in bars as much as possible. I mean, how is this guy supposed to do that if you don't provide him with an adequate supply of young, attractive female coworkers that he can hit on and perhaps even pressure into sleeping with in a drunken, sweaty night of shame-based loving? I mean, who did he even go out with these 3 times?
Once with the granny and the and I wish I hadn't gone. At the very end with 2 girls, one of them that was probably doable.
This guy loves his anti-gay slurs. Does he kiss his mirror with that mouth? You know what? I bet he does. But anyway, things seem to be looking up. Just when I was going to start a telethon for this poor pilot, he found one quote-unquote girl who was probably doable. Let's hear how it went.
One of them that was probably doable, but we ended up going to the bar and then to the crew room in St. Louis, and all these 2 women wanted to do was one wanted to berate her sister and the other wanted to bitch about her husband. Literally, for 3 hours, me and the FO. When that was done, 2:30, got back to my room, I'm like, why the f*** did I step?
Okay, whoever's transmitting, go watch what you're saying.
Yeah, that was the air traffic controller stepping in to let our hero in the sky know that, excuse me, everyone on that frequency could hear him. So that definitely shut him up. What? Oh, that didn't shut him up.
Know if I had banked them. So, I mean, it was a complete disaster for 6 months. Now I'm back in Houston, which is easily one of the ugliest bases. I mean, it's all these f***ing old dudes and grannies, and there's like maybe a handful of cute chicks.
Congratulations, flight attendants in Texas. You've just been deemed among the ugliest by the world's most discerning pilot. So how did Southwest handle the situation? Well, the pilot was reprimanded and sent to diversity training. He was also suspended without pay for some undisclosed amount of time, but this happened in March, and he's already back to work. So, the next time you're in Southwest Airlines, feel free to say hi to the pilot, but only if you're hot and not a dude. Because even though he keeps talking about dudes, he's definitely not into dudes, just hot chicks. We need to keep this guy happy. So Southwest Airlines, would it kill you to go to Hooters and maybe recruit some new flight attendants for this guy? They have wings there, same difference, right? I know flight attendants are there for our safety, and I appreciate them just as they are, but the pilot is the captain of the ship. If this guy's work environment doesn't start getting a little more girls gone wild, he's not gonna have anyone to get drunk with and hit on, and he'll be all alone, circling endlessly on the ridiculous. We'll be right back.